My clock says 8 p.m., so let's begin. This is a dream come true. First of all, thank you everybody for coming in. It's a dream come true of something that for a very long, long time I thought it would be important for us to have, especially this year as we begin to see that our situation has changed dramatically and we are not able to access our synagogues personally. The idea of extending this time of accounting of the soul to go all the way from the beginning of Elul all the way to Yom Kippurim, to Yom Kippur, is actually really, really critical. The idea that that we can ascend and cleanse ourselves and look for opportunities to look for repentance, but also for reconciliation, which that's how I also read that word of the Aseret Yemei Teshuvah, of the 10 days of repentance, but also this idea that Sephardim and Jews from Oriental Jews have carried through a long, long time, this idea of going all the way from the beginning of Elul to Yom Kippur, 40 days. The Midrash that tells us that the same 40 days that Moshe went to Mount Sinai to receive the Torah, and not to forget that he actually went twice, to remember that also Moshe had his problems, and the first of the tablets were broken and he had to come back and pick them up and begin again, as we all do every year. This year some powerful things have happened, for certainly at all levels, but especially at Shirat HaNefesh. Those of you that have been with us for a little bit, of course we honored Tisha B'Av, the 9th of Av, after 3 Shabbatot that were of sadness as we were approaching the destruction of Yerushalayim and remembering of Sinat Chinam, of actually talking ill to each other, and something that perhaps we remember now poignantly in these days. And then going a week later to Tu V'Av, the 15th of Av, where we sang all together songs of love, and the Talmud telling us that Tu V'Av, it was the happiest day of the year, together with Yom Kippur, Yom Kippurim, like they say. And so we continue on, and then now we got to this beginning of Elul. Remember that the rabbis magnificently create an acronym of Ani Ledodi Vedodi Li, as I am my beloved and my beloved is mine. Remembering that if we come back, if we make teshuvah, and sometime we make the point of saying that the teshuvah is the answer, recognizing that teshuvah, it means repentance, but in modern Hebrew also means to answer, as we will see in some of the sessions as we go along into these 28 sessions of Selihot that we have. And I wanted to show you, as we begin, a little bit of a clip of how Selihot are engaged and performed and felt in Yerushalayim. So I'm gonna give myself an opportunity to share the screen with you and show you a YouTube, just a short one, where we're going to be looking at how this happened.
Yeah.
I think this gives you a little taste of how Selichot are celebrated, not this year. I want to make sure that you understand that this is a recording. This is not happening in the state of Israel at the Kotel this year, unfortunately. But you have an idea, a taste of how is that Selichot are expressed during the month of Elul. In Israel, where young and old and everyone comes together to express, to cleanse themselves by participating, by singing together. You probably heard the words, Chatanu lefanecha rachem alenu, says we have made mistakes in front of you, God. This is, please forgive us, right? So this sensation that continues on. And I wanted to now say, first, a couple things. The first is that these sessions are dedicated to Mori Berabi, to my mentor, Rabbi Mordechai Ederi, who was born in Tangier and emigrated to Argentina. And I learned a great deal of what I know from him. Zichrono Libracha, he's not with us any longer, but his memory continues certainly with me and with all the many, many, many have studied with him. And so I wanted to post just to say that because I think it's important to recognize those that have been before us and have created the place so we can continue on in our way. The idea for this session is to talk about one of the most, the first of the slichot is called Ben Adam Ma Lecha Nirdam. So I'm going to show it to you so you can look at it. And so it's right here. Ben Adam Ma Lecha Nirdam Kum Kira Betachanunim. Let's look at the translation roughly that says, O mortal, why are you still asleep? Wake up and call pleadingly. And those words, especially poignant, because not only talk about the physical act, in many, many places it was traditional to wake up early hours at 4 or 5 o'clock in the morning. People would be knocked on their doors saying it's time for Selichot. So they were asleep and they would come up just before Shacharit to actually recite Selichot, but also, of course, as an awakening to recognize that our souls are dormant, and in many, many ways, we have a lot of work to do. And yes, it would be good to begin that work at Rosh Hashanah, but if we begin it earlier, a month before, that perhaps would actually give us a very beautiful sensation of approximation of what it means to be closer to the creator of the universe. I sometimes remind myself, so when I teach music, the idea that it's not the same to go to an opera and just appear there, that if you actually were able to listen to the music in advance, then you know who are the singers, and in perhaps you can actually dress up to go to that beautiful theater where the music is gonna be played. And I think that metaphor is apt for what's happening to us. So pour your prayer and ask for forgiveness from the master of the universe, continue saying, cleanse yourself of your actions. Do not delay before the days vanish. Run, ask for the help of the dweller on high. Please, O God, accept those that invoked your name, Israel's faithful. And it continues at the very end saying, every thought, every word is manifest before God. God, full of mercy, have mercy upon us, like a father upon his children. Justice is yours, O Adonai, and we are embarrassed of our actions. And I wanted to now show you a recording of a group called Diwan Halev. This is a group that lives in the state of Israel, many of them of Yemenite families. And this is a beautiful melody of how Diwan Alev actually sings this piyut. I'm putting it together in transliteration for you to follow. I think you get a little idea of how this works, and this beautiful Syrian melody that the Diwan Alev sings for you with all those very special instruments, the kanun and the oud. So bring us to a place, I hope, by this repetition that takes us to a different level, that takes us to a place that perhaps sometimes we cannot arrive at ourselves alone. And certainly that's the idea, that community takes us to a place that none of us alone can aspire. So what I would like to do is, to bring, somebody's asking, what does Diwan mean? So Diwan is a set of poetry that is associated with spiritual practices, and it is actually Iranian in principle, but it has been applied by Yemeni Jews and Iraqi Jews, among others. Thank you for asking that question. Let's see if we can take the time just a little bit and sing together. I'm going to share this and bring it back so we can all we can sing a little bit. Let's sing. Thank you. amot kegeber leitaber leitbado al chadayim ya erdosh bechol medrosh lecha. This feeling of Selihot is that we're going to conclude. I want to again thank all of you for coming in. I want to thank from the bottom of my heart to everyone, from the bottom of my heart to everyone that is participating on this 28-29 sessions of Selihot. I also want to thank my friend and my Rabbi Gila Langner, who has done tremendous publicity of this, and to everyone of the Shirat HaNefesh Board of Directors that made this happen, including Janet Braun, who was instrumental in continuing letting us know about it, and also the extremely talented graphic designer artist Irv Cohen, who has created some magnificent, I don't know if you've seen the candle of the JPEG, that it's just extraordinary. And I also want to remind you that tomorrow we continue looking at the sound of the shofar. Lucy Steinitz is here, and she's going to be taking us to that place where the sound of the shofar brings us to the deepest of our places, spiritually speaking. With that, I'm going to leave you. We said we're going to do something between 20 and 30 minutes. I think I'm close. Let's see. Somebody says transliterations are not all under the right phrases. They are. It's just that they come the other way. Hebrew comes right to left, and left to right is the right. But if you like it the other way, I'll try to improve that too. As part of our slichot, I ask for my forgiveness already for doing that. And yes, and let's keep together, and let's keep in this world, in this derech, in this road that takes us all the way to the Yamim Noraim, to the days of awe. Keep safe. Laila Tov, thank you so much for everything.
Laila Tov, beautiful.
Laila Tov, Yashar Koach. Just
thank you
beautiful.
So much, everybody.
Thank you.
Yeah, it's a pleasure to have you all here.
Thank you.
Right.
We'll look forward to meeting everyone over the next 28 nights.
Exactly, exactly, exactly.
Muy lindo, Ramon.
Gracias, Estrella. Good. All right, good night.
Ya estamos todos.
Muchas gracias.
Okay, thank you.
That's nice.